So we're in Mosque Road, we're in the heart of Bangalore, and we're here doing a food trail. Now Mosque Road is famous for non-vegetarian food, and this also happens to be the holy month of Ramadan. So that's the reason why we've come here bright and early, to get here before the crowd does and to explore some great food. Hi Aslam.
Hey Kripal, how are you?
Good to see you, man.
Good to see you too, and it's been a while.
Yeah, absolutely.
So Aslam is a dear friend, of course, and he's food lover number one. So Aslam, what's food in Mosque Road all about?
This is the month of Ramadan. The whole city is observing that, the country and the world. And really the action is on Ramadan. Apart from the whole piousness and the month of giving and the month of abstinence, a very other big aspect of it is the food.
It's food, that's
yeah.
And of course I understand that you're fasting. And
I am fasting.
So we're going to be beginning the food trail with me eating and Aslam guiding.
And I will break my fast along the way.
You'll break your fast along the way, and we'll take it from there.
So in Bangalore, there are two, three areas which are very popular as far as the whole Ramadan food is concerned. And of course, the one which has really attained a lot of popularity is this whole strip, which is called Mosque Road.
So we are where the action is. And the other thing is also that the eateries that are here are not just available only for Ramadan, right?
Yeah.
So you've got most of the eateries that are open year round.
Yes. Exactly the place where we are standing, which is the Albert Bakery, and I think it goes back like some 70-80 years if my information is correct. This place has been here serving some of the most delicious food and very similarly consistent food throughout the year.
So Aslam, I can't wait to get started on this food trail. So we're going to make a start right here at Albert Bakery and go in and pick up some scrumptious baked goodies. The shop is so crowded that I don't think the cameras can go in, but we're going to go in and get some delicious fare out here for all of you to see. Let's go, Aslam.
Absolutely.
So we've got a range of goodies from Albert's Bakery to begin our food trail here on Mosque Road. So Aslam, what have we got from Mosque Road now?
You've got some chota samosa, which is mutton keema.
And then you have...
And this is the very, very famous brain puff.
Brain puff, okay. Yeah. And then we have a couple of other things.
Yeah, so we have the keema naan and we also have the kua naan.
So Aslam, I can't wait to get started.
Yes.
And I think we'll probably make a beginning with these mini bite-sized mutton samosas. So this is the famous Albert Bakery mutton samosa. Deliciousness in one bite, actually two bites. I love the flakiness of the pastry.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a delicious bite of meaty goodness. So it's delicately spiced.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah,
it's not overly spicy.
Yeah,
it's not too greasy at the same time, and it feels moist yet dry when you eat it. This is super delicious. Wow, look
at that. Brain puff.
This is hot. So let's open this up first and see what's inside. You can see the beja or the brain, and you've got onions, you've got some spice, probably some turmeric. This looks super special. It's hot and it's got all that custardy goodness of the brain. You can feel the brain, the beja, literally dissolve in your mouth. Super special, super. So we just finished with two delicious treats at Albert Bakery. So we're going to go next.
Across the roads. And what we will get there is the famous Haleem from Pista House, Hyderabad.
Oh, lovely.
It really comes only this month. Of course, you can taste it, and I think it's just mind-blowingly delicious.
Excellent. So we're going to go taste some Haleem, and then hopefully somewhere along the way, still enjoy some of these goodies that we still have.
Keema naan and the khoa naan.
So we'll reveal it a little later, hopefully.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
If we are not too full by then. What we're going to do now is we're going to taste some special Pista House Haleem. They only make a Haleem with mutton, that's the real deal. Wow! You should look at this huge pot of Haleem that they have here. They're probably about 40 kilos of Haleem that's right here. And all this is going to be sold out?
Yes.
Before the end of the evening. Fantastic. Ek milega hame. look at all that. So he's going to now get some lemon, some mint and roasted onions. Lovely. We've just paid him 250 rupees for this bucket of delicious mutton haleem and some kubani ka meat. Aslam, I can't wait to taste this.
So let's go and sit down.
And so right now we are in the basement of the Pista House Haleem outlet here on Mosque Road. And I've got this beautiful velvety Pista House haleem here. Of course, I know that a traditional haleem is always mutton.
So I think mutton is really the haleem. And then there are variations of that.
I mean, look at all this gooey goodness.
And that's taken like almost 8 to 10 or 12 hours to make.
8 to 12 hours, and the meat and the wheat is all pounded together.
So you know, the way this goes is that they have that secret spice and mutton and the quantities and all. But the trick is to keep on gotoing it all through the preparation.
So keep on eating it.
Is that right?
So the right way to do, so we've already got some coriander and some mint in it.
So what you do, you throw in some of the
lemon. Yeah. So we'll just squeeze in some of the lemon.
That's it? Yeah. And then you
put some of the brishta.
Yeah, that's good. A little more.
Some onion here.
Yeah.
And then we...
Just take it with that crunch and...
Lovely.
Yeah.
Oh, lovely. I've got a nice piece of meat. It's almost velvety in its texture.
It is.
And you got the burnt onions or the brishta that gives it a nice bite. So basically it's a complete meal.
Meal by itself. And that is why it is very popular during the Ramadan month.
So you've got the savouriness, you've got the meatiness of the meat. You've got that velvety texture. You've got the crunch of the brishta, the burnt onions. And then you've got that citrusy twang of the lemon. And you also get a bit of the bite, a bit of the zestiness of the mint that comes in this Pista House haleem. The only thing, when you're eating this, you got to be a little mindful of the bones.
Yeah, because you see, when it's pounded, the flesh leaves it, and that's why the bones are there. But the bones also add the flavor.
You can get a sense of some of the, so you can see the meat here, you can see the chili, and of course, all the spices that have been beaten completely into the haleem. You know, what I really like about this haleem is that gentle searing heat. This is probably the perfect dish.
Absolutely. Perfect and all that you can eat if you don't want to eat anything else.
Beautiful thing about the Pista House haleem is that it comes in these jars or these dabbas, and you can just pack it and take it home. After the haleem, next we try the famous kubani ka meetha, an apricot based dessert.
So this is a very Hyderabad special.
You can definitely taste the richness.
I think it's got saffron also in it, right?
It has saffron and it is sweet, but it's perfect after a taste of the haleem.
Exactly.
There's a lot of sugary goodness that you taste in this kubani ka meetha. Delicious. So we're going to taste some of this Kheema naan and the Khoa naan from Albert's across the road. So this is pre-sliced. You can see all the goodness of the Kheema naan. There's some curry leaf here as well. They call it a naan, but it's almost like it's a puff pastry.
It's a puff pastry, exactly.
There's a lot of onion that you taste in this.
Yes.
There is a meat, but it's a lot of the onion. And I think the meat just is in there to give it that slight, savory, meaty sort of a flavor. But if you have one of these just by yourself, you probably don't need dinner after that. A tasty indulgence though. The Khoa naan. It's like a stuffed pizza, almost like a calzone. You can see all that Khoa, all that milk solid which is right here. You know what I really like about this? Is that it's not overly sweet.
Yes.
You know, you taste that dairy goodness, you taste all that milk solid, all that milk that's condensed, but thankfully, it's low on the sugar. So, I think I can have another bite of the Khoa naan from Albert Bakery. So, we're still on the food trail here on Mosque Road. It's been raining a bit, so we've been ducking in and out of towers, and we've arrived at Kheema.
So Kheema is a part of the Empire Restaurant Group.
Okay.
But because the Empire Restaurant exists across the road.
That's Empire right
that's
there.
That's Empire.
So we see there's a Ramzan food mela there. So we're going to go in there, take a look at what's happening. But the dish that we have for is the Nihari.
With the Karachi naan.
With the Karachi naan. So let's go in and take a look at what's happening at the food mela. So these are some Arabic style.
Yeah.
Dishes. So you got the chicken alfaham.
This is actually, sir, very famous in our restaurant. This is the mutton paya.
The mutton paya. I can see all that goodness of all that gelatin. Lovely. It's hot and it's quite nourishing. I'm going to take some of this naan and dunk it into the paya. You can taste all that nourishment that comes from the lamb trotter and also the gelatin that's rendered into this broth here. And the naan works beautifully well to absorb all the flavors of the paya. Delicious. The weather, it's raining out there, and this steaming bowl of paya with some naan to dunk into it is just what you need. We just tasted a delicious paya and we are in here at Kheema to taste the gosht nihari with the Karachi naan. Aslam tells me that's a speciality.
It is, it is. In fact, it's an amazing breakfast dish. Of course, it's available throughout the day. There's a lot of Middle Eastern influence on the food here.
You know, when I come here and look at something like this and you look at all these beautiful curries, you look at all these juicy kebabs and the lamb mandi on top, I want to have one of each. You know, that's the problem that I have.
They all look delicious.
They all look delicious. So I think let's quickly run inside before we change our mind and order more dishes. So let's go in. It looks amazing. Karachi naan, oh my goodness. Look at the size of this naan. Wow. I'm sure the nihari is soaked in all that goodness of this delicious stew that we have here. So let's taste the nihari.
Just break with your hand and dunk the bread in it. Soak it rather.
There you have it, the beautiful piece of the lamb shank, the kareli. You know, all this gelatin that's, you know, that's infused from the bones. Karachi naan works beautifully well to soak up all that sticky goodness of the Nalli Nihari. This Nalli Nihari here at Kheema is super special.
Do subscribe and stay tuned to Food Lovers TV to catch the second part of this episode as Aslam and I explore more delicious food on this trail.
Mutton
chops.
And this just looks delicious, Aslam.
Absolutely. Lovely place, which I think has some of the best pathar gosht, then pal, and sheikh kebab.
Now it's time for the Suleimani.